So I think we should buy a house together. What are your thoughts?
Honestly, I don't know if we're there yet in our relationship.
Everybody, hope everybody is having an amazing day. My name is Mark Doner. If you guys are new here, welcome to the donation. I'm gonna apologize in advance for today's vlog if I, you know, don't have a lot of energy because I have a sore throat, guys, and I am ill. I'm feeling very, very ill.
I'm dying, help me.
Yeah, probably because you raged at G-Eazy last night.
I was actually feeling sick before the concert, guys, but Kylie and I went to the G-Eazy concert last night. He brought out Travis Scott, he brought out Halsey, he brought out Baby Rexha. Who else did he bring out, babe?
Brought out my wild side.
If you guys know me, you know that I love G-Eazy. But anyways, getting into today, earlier I opened up a gift from a fan that was sent to my door for hitting 2 million subscribers. So yeah, my throat hurts really bad. So get this, I can't scream today. You're welcome. I got a ring on my doorbell the other day. There was a package. I was like, I didn't order anything, and it was to me from Urban Outfitters. Turns out, a fan, Sammy Taylor, I always see your tweets, shout out to you. She sent me something. Congratulations on hitting 2 million on YouTube. At Sammy Taylor, always plug, there it is. And look how cool it is. It's a peace neon light sign. We got the Deuces neon sign. I'm just gonna have to figure out how to plug it in and... Oh, it fits perfect.
It fits perfect.
You ready? Hey! Thank you, Sammy Taylor, I appreciate you. You guys are a fan and you wanna send me some stuff, feel free. Shout out to Sammy for that, and then Kylie and I, we went to go look at this house. You know, I wasn't feeling too well vlogging there, so, you know, pardon my lack of energy.
Flash. Yo, the backyard goals. How do you feel about this place?
I'll be tanning right over there.
Super sick pool, guys. Look at this. They have a basketball court back there. They have a tennis court. See the trees blocking it in, the fence around the whole backyard. There's a tennis court back here mixed with a basketball court. Brand new hoops with lights, nighttime game.
What?
And then obviously the dope pool. Look at the back end of it. The kitchen is very new and sleek.
Let's be honest, I'm the only one that will be in the kitchen.
Exactly, but you'll be cooking for me. Nice island right here. That thing right there cooks meals when someone uses it, aka her. Moving on over, this is like a nice dining area. Nice little living room action. Here's another living room.
Ooh, where you'll meet
the bar. Here's the master bedroom, pretty nice.
I have something to show you, watch, look how cool this is, okay?
What?
This is big enough for my clothes, and then they even put up a spot up in the attic for your shit.
Yeah, funny. The master bedroom has this balcony out here, which is absolutely massive, and then it overlooks the beauty, so every day you could see how nice your house is.
Get out of the pool.
All right, we don't have kids, relax.
Hunter, get out of the pool. That was gonna be a dog's name, but that was just really awkward.
Males, females.
This is where I would put all my makeup, and this would be mine as well. You would get that one over there.
I would get this one, I'd get the toilet, because it's on my half.
That's fine, you need the toilet.
The only weird thing is, though, is when you're showering, like, you could literally see outside to the street. That's kind of weird, so.
True.
Awkward. The front yard too is gated and also has a nice 3-car garage. Look how dope this place looks. What do you think, babe? Overall, your thoughts, questions, concerns?
I really, really like it. There's only 2 downfalls for me.
What are the downfalls?
There's only 1 bathroom for 3 bedrooms to share upstairs.
Besides the master,
besides
yes.
Ours. And then 2, that if I was naked in the shower, someone could potentially see me.
Yeah. But it has a pool, a basketball court, a tennis court, 2-car.
Yeah, there's a lot of pros to it.
Back. So the house is actually really dope. There's just some downsides. It's actually 30 minutes away from where we live now in Hollywood. It's kind of in a suburb. Also, like Kylie mentioned, that the 3 other bedrooms upstairs, they share 1 bathroom, which is a very big negative. If we want to live with some other people, then they have to share another bathroom with 3 other people. Yikes.
No! God, please, no! 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 No!
But on the positive side, 3-car garage, dope backyard, privacy, lit level 1000. You know the vlogs will be lit there. We just have to make a decision. Do we want to move there? Do we want to rent somewhere else? I don't think I'm going to be staying in this apartment. Kylie, what are your thoughts, babe?
I think it's an amazing house, although I think those are 2 really big downfalls. And I think it's more for like a family.
And you know, we don't plan on having any kids anytime soon.
2 hours later.
Hey guys, me again. So I just spent the last 4 hours sleeping and napping because I'm just not feeling too well. My throat over here is hurting me. Problem is, I got my tonsils taken out a long time ago, so I don't even have tonsils, so I don't know how I have a sore throat. But anyways, regardless, we've been sitting here right now, and we're on this new app called Vero. I have no idea what it is.
The British lad herself. What is the word for female instead of lad? Lad's like a dude.
I don't know. Guy, dude, lad, mate.
Mate. The British mate herself told us to get it. Are you popping on Vero?
I have a whole 4 followers, but all my people are asleep right now.
Damn. Weak!
The TV just turned on!
Cool!
There's a ghost in the house!
And if you ask, hop in on Vero. Kelly Ray, come find me, not me.
So guys, the follow requests are coming in for Vero. Apparently it's this new hot social media app. I don't really know what it is, but I'm gonna show you guys it. I'm pretty popping. I have 55 followers. Go follow me so I can be number one. Basically, it's a hub for like anything you want. It's like a new social media. Yeah, let's
Not sure why Kylie's trying to interrupt my vlog during my promo of Vero, guys, but go add me on Vero so I can become number one.
Me and Kylie are in competition right now. Who can get the most followers? The donation is so much stronger, babe. Oh. Look at them coming in. 62 followers. What are you at?
I could kill you.
47, yo. Do you even Vero?
You posted like 20 minutes before.
Oh,
me.
Do you even Vero? Yeah, take my phone.
Guys, go add all of us on Vero. I'm Mark Doner, she's Kylie Rae, she's Mandy Celine. We're gonna be the poppinest people on Vero. We got this, let's go. Donation, let's go.
Come be one of the first 100 to follow me, guys. Hopefully by the time you see this, I won't have 100 yet, but I have 65 right now. Popping off, let's go, follow me.
Anyways, guys, while the follows on Vero are pouring in, I actually just hit 100, so sorry. Be the first 1,000 to follow me. Yeah, it's crazy, I know, I'm popping on Vero. Comment down below, please, some home remedies for my throat to feel better because I don't want to go to the doctor. I've always used orange juice as my home remedy and tea. And I gargle salt water. That's what my dad always taught me. What do you do?
My mom's always taught me to gargle salt water.
Kylie and I have a decision to make. So we went and looked at a house today and we've been thinking, my lease is up May 11th and this is my apartment. We've been thinking, do we move in together? Do we buy? Do we rent? Do we not move in together? See, we've been dating for how long?
Mr.
Why would you eat something when we're vlogging? I'm not gonna sit here and wait an hour for you to chew.
Like your dad?
God.
Me and his dad have a lot of habits that are the same.
We'll have a conversation and then we'll just start eating. Like, oh, cool. Like, let me wait 10 more minutes for you to finish chewing.
Anyways, what was the question again?
How long have we been dating?
What are we in? February? I feel like almost a year.
Almost a month? Wow.
Almost a full month.
So yeah, we've almost been dating a year. Are we moving fast if we buy a house together? I think that's kind of moving fast.
Yes, it's fast.
Mandy off screen. Yes,
I know.
So I don't know if the move is to buy or to rent a place together or we get our own separate places. I don't know. What do you think, Kylie? Because she's been posing the idea. She's been avoiding it. She she brought it up the other day like, hey.
So this is something I don't want to talk about, but like we kind of need to talk about it. It's coming closer than we think. So are we going to buy? Are we going to rent? Are we going to do it together? Do this separately? Like, what is the ish, you know?
Basically, guys, if you are in a relationship, let me know.
Yeah.
This is such an awkward talk.
I know.
And we're sharing it with you guys because we haven't even had this talk and now I'm trying
to get... I feel really uncomfortable right now. If we had to be honest, we've had this conversation, like I am born and raised in California, right? So I've been very fortunate to have my parents pretty close to here. So I haven't needed to, let's say, rent an apartment like someone like Mark who's coming here out of state. So he has no choice other than to rent a place because he's not going to move out here and live, you know, on someone's couch. I've always wanted to buy just because I'm so fortunate of having my parents close by. For instance, you pay X amount of dollars on this apartment. In a year, you've spent X amount in the year on this apartment.
And I'll never get it again.
You'll never get it again. Every check that you write every month, you'll never see it again. And in fact, you're paying for someone else to own this property with every time you pay rent. So that's the way that I look at it. So I really want to buy. So then the question comes in, do we buy together? Well, you see, I can't really buy all on my own right now. It would be great to have you. As far as like the moving fast, I get it. But I think that like, I don't know, I've already kind of lived with you for so long. And I don't know, we get along really, really well. So like, God forbid anything did happen where we decided, I don't see it ever ending in like a bad way. It would, if anything, just be because we just aren't a mutual agreement that it doesn't work out. This is so weird. No, I'm saying we don't.
So we would just still live together.
Either
that. And then you just start dating someone.
someone else and I start dating someone. No, we still live it. This is my ex-girlfriend, Kylie. No. We actually kind of got into this thing a year ago where we bought this house together, so we can't really get out of
it. I think that, no, because you could buy someone out of the house. So I think if, God forbid, anything ever happened, I could always buy you out.
Oh, gotcha.
So you could move out.
No, okay. Yeah, you kicked me out?
No, I'm totally just kidding. I just think that, like, I don't know.
Yeah, we don't know. We're kind of in a little predicament, but the house we did look at today was really sick. Only problem is it's...
I don't like the flooring. Sorry, I'll say it. Relax. I don't like the flooring.
I like the whole house. It was really sick. The only downsides, as we mentioned, were the bathrooms. And then also the fact that it's really far away. But in California, it's kind of crazy. So obviously the closer you are to Hollywood...
And the more expensive.
The more expensive. And it's outrageously so expensive. For example, me being from Ohio, this house we looked at today, I'm just going to be upfront and honest with you guys, was $1.4 million. In Ohio, for $1.4 million, I would have one of the biggest houses in my neighborhood growing up. Like, if not the biggest. So it's hard for me to be like, spend that kind of money on a house when I know how much more I can get in Ohio.
Yeah, but you're living in
Ohio. You're paying for location. But this house, say we looked at this house in Hollywood, it'd probably be like $4 or $5 million.
Probably like three, probably like.
Cause it has a basketball court, it has a pool, tennis court, it's 4,500 square feet.
I just feel like this is more for like
a family
with like three kids that are young growing up, cause they can all like share the bathroom. But let's say if we had like one of my girlfriends move in and one of your guy friends moving in, a guy and a girl sharing a bathroom that aren't a couple is just no bueno. Yeah.
The house was sick. Honestly, I could picture it as being like kind of my dream house.
Okay. Like, let's not get too ahead of ourselves. Okay. This is not the dream house.
Oh, all right.
Just giving my opinion.
I don't even know what the title of this vlog. Do I title it, we don't know where we're at in our relationship? Do I title it, we're getting a new house? Do I title it, she might break up with me in a year and buy my house out? Or do I title it, follow us on Vero so we can be number one?
So I think we should buy a house together. What are your thoughts?
I don't know if we're there yet in our relationship.
Are you kidding me?
Boy, bye.
Boy, bye.
Anyways, guys, that is gonna do it for today's vlog. I hope I feel better. Make sure you guys beat you and swoop up some merch, don'ts.com. Be a savage. As I mentioned before, comment down below some home remedies to make me feel a little bit better. And if you guys think we should move in together, I don't know, Kylie, what are you thinking?
Well, now I'm saying, Dad, I'll buy my own house.
All right, then I'll move in with
you. I'm totally just kidding because I don't have enough money for that, so I'm gonna need you.
And I'll see you guys all on Wednesday with a brand new vlog. So did it stay with me one time. Deuce!